Good morning. I have talked to you about some of the problems that we deal with as we face. We have depression, we have fear, and what was the third thing? Apathy. Today I'm going to start on a fourth thing. A fourth thing that we suffer from, and this is a very touchy subject. Because if God calls it a sin, but the world accepts it, it is one of the most socially acceptable sins in our culture. And this is called greed. What is it called? Greed. Okay. Do you know what greed is? Do you know what is greed? No? Have you ever been told by someone, don't be greedy? That sounds familiar. Now the greed is a desire to have more. That is called greed. There are many manifestations of greed. In business, greed is called success. Yeah? Because the businessman who has a lot of money, has amassed a lot of wealth, we call him successful without thinking, how has he got that money? How many people has he exploited? How many people have suffered because of it? You know, sometimes when I interview grade 11 students, and I ask them, especially the commerce students, why do you want to take commerce? Some say, give some reason, some give some reason, and some say very bluntly, I want to be successful, I want to make a lot of money. Now that is called greed. Okay? How much is enough? Tell me. Sometimes we wonder. We read about Lakshmi Mittal. Have you heard about him? He's a very big steel magnate. In fact, he's so rich, he has bought up castles in England and France. When he got married, he hired the palace of the old king of France to hold the reception for his daughter. Yeah? We read of businessmen like the Ambani brothers. Yes. And we call them successful. Bible calls them greedy. And not just the rich are greedy, even others like us, we are also greedy. How to get more? In order to get more, we try all sorts of things. We buy lottery tickets. Sounds familiar? Yeah? Pay bribes. Yes? In the old days, they used to ask, if a boy came to marry a girl, the girl's family would ask, what's your salary? Now then, after some time it became, what is your salary plus extra income? So the salary may be very little, but the extra income, that is called the bribes, was more. How much is enough? That's greed. We overwork, we overspend. Shopping. Shopping for things we don't really need is another form of greed. Does that sound familiar? Yeah? Yesterday I was out shopping, day before Saturday, with my granddaughter. It was her birthday. I said, you can spend money. So I'll take you. Where do you want to go? So she said, I want to go to a shop called Cares. I said, okay, I don't know what that shop is. So on the way, there were many other shops and she stopped there. And then she said, Nani, can I get this? Nani, can I get this? I said, you have only this much money to spend now. Think carefully. You said you want to go to some shop. Think about it, how much you will need there. So she started. She wanted this also. She wanted a necklace. She wanted a shoe. She wanted this. Then finally we reached here, and that's another shop full of necklaces and earrings and bracelets and all. You know that. Well, she spent 45 minutes there looking at I don't know how many months we had in our box back at home, but she wanted it home. Yeah? Have you ever heard of something it's called a price tag moment? You see something? Oh, you like it. You put it up, perfect, fits perfectly. And then your heart beating, you reach for that little piece of paper on it called the price tag. And with beating heart, you turn it around and you look at all the digits there. Yeah? And then what you have, what is called a sticker moment. Yeah? You might be very happy with what you read there and say, yeah, I can get this, I can get this. Or you may look at it and you say, oh, I can't buy it now. So you give it back and then you start scheming. You start plotting. You start planning. I have so much I got from my birthday. Next birthday I will get some more. So I start talking. Can you give me my next birthday's money now? Greed. Greed. This is all greed. I'm going to read to you a story from the Bible about a man. Luke calls him a ruler. Matthew calls him a young ruler. Both of them call him rich. So this is the story of the rich young ruler. He had everything. He was successful. He had scored good points. He had a lot of money. He had made money. He had in his business. He was good. Not only that, he had become a ruler. So in position he was good. And now he comes to Jesus. Yeah. He says he wants to start investing in the world to come. So he says, how can I get to heaven? What must I do in order to get to heaven? See, he wants to make a deal. Yeah? A transaction. What is the reply of the Lord Jesus? He starts small. He says, keep the commands. Honor your father and mother. Don't speak lies. Don't kill. Don't commit adultery. Don't steal. Oh, he says, wonderful, yeah? I've been doing this. I've done all that. Been there, done that. What else do I have to do? Lord Jesus says, all 10. You have done all 10. Yes, yes, all 10. Not only have I done all 10, I've done it from the time I was a little boy. Oh. Then the Lord Jesus pauses and says, okay, then there's only one thing left. Sell what you have. Sell all that you have. Give it to the poor. And come and follow me. That was the price tag moment for that rich young ruler. He looked at the price to gain heaven. And then he grew quiet. He slowly slid across the bench, got up, and slowly walked out. The Lord Jesus said loud enough for him to hear, how difficult it is for rich people to enter heaven. Now, I'm going to read out one more verse and then I'm closed because we have the thundering of the clouds and the forecast is rain. But I think we need to understand the greed. Bible calls it a sin. And to see where it is placed. This is in Colossians chapter 3 and verse 5 and 6. Put to death therefore what is earthly in you. Now look at the list. Sexual immorality, impurity, passion, evil desire, greed which is idolatry. On account of these, the wrath of God is coming. It places greed along with sexual immorality, impurity, passion, evil desire. And it calls greed as idol worship, idolatry. Now what's idolatry? When the place which belongs to God you give to something or somebody else. That's idolatry. This young man had given that place which belonged to God to his money, to his position, to his wealth. Have you done that in your life? Is there something else which is in that place where God should be? That's it. Next week, I'm going to talk to you a little more about this, and I'll be telling you about the lies which greed tells you. I'm going to tell you about the